Yo, what is up, guys? It's Randy CR here. In today's video, I'm going to give you guys the best defensive log bait deck. The E-Spirits for all the Evolution Bats players. Everyone's using Bats, even though they're not evolved. And then the Arrows and Bomb Tower is for more of like Splash, so more for like the Evo Recruits, because people are still using them. I hope you guys enjoy this video. Like and subscribe if you guys do, and I'll see you guys in the first game. Alright guys, we're in the first game against the Hammer. I think I'll just cycle an E-Spirit in the middle, we'll see. The reason why I don't have Mighty Miner or my Barbs evolved is because the Evo Knight is so good. It's probably one of the best cards in the game, honestly. But another matchup besides Evo Bats and the Evo Recruits decks is also Goblin Giant Sparky. Everyone and their mother is playing that deck right now. So this deck's really good against it, honestly. There's a lot of like spam as well. This deck is really aggressive, like as well as good on defense. So this is my favorite defensive log bait deck that's also like pressure, like you can pressure them with. Okay, he just plays an Ice Spirit Firecracker. That's going to pretty much full counter my barrel. I'm just going to play my Bomb Tower all the way down low. And if he EQs, I'm just going to play my Knight. If not, I'll just play an E-Spirit down low. Yeah, okay, I'll just play my E-Spirit. Okay, I completely messed that up. Oops, I have to play my Knight. But yeah, I strongly recommend you guys try this out. If you guys are in like mid-ladder or something, it's really solid. There's no log in this deck though, but you do have arrows. You could take out E-Spirit for log, but I really recommend you guys play with E-Spirit. I honestly do. Just because of all the people that use bats. I'm just gonna barrel the- wait, he might have NATO. Oops. Let's see what he does right now. Okay, he has log. He either has log fireball though, and or log, what's it called? Log earthquake. I'll just play my bomb tower down low, and I'm gonna instantly play my goblin gang. What the heck? Okay, well, this deck's really good on defense unless you miss your bomb towers like that. So, this guy's already up by 1,000 damage. Awesome. I'm just going to cycle my knight in the back of 10 elixir. Get back to my evil one. If he, I need to know if... wait, did he earthquake that? I honestly was not paying attention. Because if he has EQ, this is such a good matchup for me. Because it's kind of like fireball bait in some way. It really is because of the barbs. I'm going to instantly barrel right now to force out the log. And then I'm going to spam this guy out. And then I can just cycle arrows on his, what's it called? On his firecracker. I'll just do this right now. I can just arrows that. I'm also going to play my barbs right now. This would be really, really annoying. I'm going to play my Evo Knight at the bridge as well. Look at how annoying this push is. Like, it seems like really easy to defend, but it's just so super, super annoying. And then I'm going to play my Dark Goblin in the middle because he's about to log. Nice. And then I'm going to play my Goblin Gang as well. And then I need to get back to another set of arrows for the Dark Goblin. I mean the firecracker. I'm just gonna cycle them now. Look at the left side. Look how much damage that is. That might be his whole tower. Yeah, it almost is. So that's exactly what I was talking about, how this deck is so good at pressuring people as well as really good on defense, unless you miss bomb towers like Randy. But yeah, he has to log on this. Completely fine with it. I'm just gonna cycle a Dark Goblin in the back and then just bomb tower on his push, because he's gonna go in with a Hog Rider. I already know it. Okay, he actually goes in on that side. I'm just going to play my E-Spirit all the way up high. I think I have to play my Knight. Yeah, because I completely missed my Bomb Tower once again because I'm good at the game. I'm going to put my Barbs in front. He has to play his Log on this. Okay, I'm just going to play my Arrows. Okay, he wastes his Log, so I can just play my Dark Goblin Barrel right now. And this should be a good game. You can't really do anything about it. Yeah, he misses the Dark Goblin. And that's going to get at least one hit on the tower. So yeah, terrible game for me. But like, yeah, you guys get the point how good this deck is on defense. All right, guys. We're in the next game against Ran. Now I'm going to actually play defensively. Definitely won't be pressuring my guy a lot and spamming him out. Definitely going to be playing defensively. Anyways, okay, he just misses his zap. Great start to the game. He could be playing Goblin Giant Sparky. I'm just going to play my Goblin Gang on the left. Okay, he actually plays that. He probably has Snowball then. I'm just going to put my Dark Goblin right now. He definitely has a few spells for my barrel, 100%. Okay, I was going to play my Arrows, but I think I'm just going to play my Knight, actually. It should also activate my King Tower as well, I think. Nope. Okay, well, I can just put my E-Spirit on it now, so same thing. Who cares? Okay, wait, never mind. I have to play my Arrows. Yeah, I'm just going to put my E-Spirit and then Goblin Gang. I'm trying to save my Barbs for anything else you might have. And then I'm actually going to barrel with this right now. See, I need to know what spell he has right now. Okay, well, he just played his Zap. Okay, I can't play my Dark Goblin because he's going to just balloon the bridge. So I thought those minions go, unfortunately. That's what happens when you go too aggressive. Especially in single elixir, that's really what it is. Like, even if you have a really good defensive deck, you're going to lose if you play too aggressive. It doesn't matter if you're on top ladder or mid ladder or just terrible at the game. If you play too aggressive in general, you're going to lose. Oh, wait, can my E-Spirit block this Firecracker? Nice. I'm going to put my E-Spirit as well. And then I do have a counter push here. Wait, I'm actually going to put my Goblin Gang behind this. What does he have on this? Okay, he just poisons. That's going to be a decent amount of damage, dude. Yeah, nice. And then, okay, he's going to play a Zap, but I can't. I don't have anything to tank for it, unfortunately. So he's just going to Zap on it. That's fine with me. Okay, he actually plays a Mini Pekka. I'm just going to split my barbs in the back like this. It looks kind of weird, but in case he has, like, Fireball or anything, I don't want to give him too much value. And then I'm just going to play my, okay, I'm just going to cycle back to another Dark Alvin. I'll just waste my Dark Alvin. That's fine. But see what he plays on the left. Okay, he has a Mega Knight. Awesome. Boy, there's a random Mega Knight. Every video we play against one random Mega Knight. Oh, wait, my Dark Alvin's getting so much damage on the tower. Wait, I'm going to play my Evo Knight right now. This should be pretty easy defense because Evo Knight's broken. I'm going to put my barbs on top of this. And then also Firecracker on top of the, Dark Alvin on top of the Firecracker. No shot. Okay, the bomb tower killed it. There's no way the Firecracker survived that. And then I can just E-Spirit on this balloon. It's all dead. I just need, I think, one set of arrows. How much does it do? I don't know. I'm just going to put my knight all the way up high. I need to defend first. No, I thought I had a Goblin Gang in cycle. Oops. Oopsies. I might have to just let that Prince go, honestly. Actually, no. I'm just going to put my bomb tower E-Spirit right now. I don't think this guy had any spells, so it was a pretty easy matchup. I think that just takes the tower, right? Nope, it doesn't, because I suck. It's fine, though. It should only be death damage, and I just need one more set of arrows, and I win the game. So, yeah, that's going to be a pretty solid game against this guy. He had nothing to protect my, kill my stuff on defense. Alright, guys, we're in the next game against this guy. I'm still sick, guys. It's really hurting my throat to talk this much, but I'm just going to put my knight all the way down low. So yeah, apologies for that. This video is definitely going to be shorter than normal. Okay, I'm just going to cycle my arrows on the right side. I don't know why he has a princess and a bandit, but you do you, man. I kind of want to play my E-Spirit behind this. Okay, he just plays that. I'm just going to cycle my Dark Goblin all the way in the back. I actually don't have arrows in this deck, which sucks, but I can just put my Goblin Gang on this. That's going to clean all of it up. I'm also going to play my E-Spirit up high so the Rascals don't get any damage. Okay, he Fireballs. That was really bad. Honestly, I think I'm just gonna play my, okay, I need 10 elixir for this. I'm gonna barrel right now. Actually, okay, I'm gonna just put my barbs down low. He's gonna play his princess. I was gonna barbs the bridge and then arrows on his princess. I'm just waiting for him to play it. Yeah, I'm just gonna play it right now. I'm gonna play my Dark Goblin behind this. He has to log this, so then I'm just gonna barrel goblins to the left side in a second here. Okay, wait, what was that? Wait, why did he just waste his Goblin Gang at the bridge? That was definitely a finger slip, right? Because I can just play my Goblin Gang behind this now. Wait, I'm going to put my Goblin Gang behind this and then just barrel. I'm going to E-Spirit down low. I should have ignored that. What am I doing? It doesn't matter. I can still get my barrel down. And that should be tower. Well, not tower, but like a lot of his tower. Actually, no, that's going to be tower. Yeah, what was he doing? Yeah, and I got the E-Spirit down on his barrel. So I pretty much took no barrel damage. And the Panda Ties. That couldn't have gone any better, honestly. He probably just gave up. I have my barbs as well for his princess or Dark Alvin. Like, that's what I was saying. This deck's super good on defense, and it's good on offense as well. I'm just going to cycle my bomb tower in the middle so he can't go in. Okay, yeah, I knew he didn't give up. Okay, he just straight up fireballs that. I have my Evo Knight in cycle, so I'm not worried about this defense at all. I'm just going to put my Evo Knight all the way down low. I'm going to Dark Alvin the right side. That was a terrible princess. I'm just going to Goblin Gang E-Spirit. I'm not even going to play my arrows on it. It's going to full counter it. And then I think I'm just going to barrel the... I might just go for his three crown. Actually, no, I'm going to do this. He's going to fireball, so he has nothing now for my barrel. Okay, he just plays that. That's fine. I'm just getting bored. This guy obviously can't win the game anymore. I'm just going to put my bomb tower like this. He might go for the right side now. I have my Goblin Gang ready. Okay, I'm actually just going to play my arrows on this. And I'll put my Goblin Gang down low so this bandit doesn't dash on my tower. I'll play an E-Spirit as well to help out with the Rascals on the right side. And then I'll just put my barbs right on top of both of the princesses. And yeah, this guy's just not going to break through, dude. Like, he's just simply not going to. Yeah, he couldn't really do anything. So good game against this dude. Alright guys, we're in the next game against Common. Just saying, in case you guys don't know, you obviously don't have Mighty Miner in this deck. So you need to use your Knight as your big tank. And you especially need to cycle your knight as many times as possible because you really want to get back to the evil one. You really do. Okay, I think this guy's playing either Lava Hound or Graveyard. We'll see right now.
I think this is a really good matchup. Okay, he's playing graveyard. This should be a really good matchup. Yeah, it definitely is, because I have so much spam. I'm just going to cycle my arrows on this before he can get his Skelly King down. Hopefully, he doesn't have a Skelly King. I'm just going to play my Dark Goblin all the way up high. I know it looks kind of stupid, because he's going to play a Baby Dragon. I'm just going to Bomb Tower, actually, to block it. No shot, dude. Bro, there is no way that Bomb Tower didn't get in front of that Baby Dragon. You know what? It's whatever. I just have to really overcommit on this. I'm going to play my E-Spirit right now to block the first wave of Baby Dragon shots. And that's going to full counter it. So, looking pretty solid. He has Poison Bar Barrel. He shouldn't have Nado, but he actually might. So, I'm actually going to... No, he definitely does. He definitely has three spells. So, let's just see what he plays on this. Okay, he just plays a Bar Barrel. I kind of just want to cycle arrows, honestly. I think I'm going to. Actually, no, I'm just going to cycle my knight in the back, because I can block the bridge with barbs as well, if he plays a knight at the bridge on the left. Okay, he plays his knight as well. I'm just going to cycle arrows. I don't want to give him any value with his poison and play my Dark Goblin in the back. I think I'm just going to let this go. Okay, I'm actually going to Dark Goblin up high now. He has nothing to kill my Dark Goblin. Actually, he's going to poison this. Okay, no, he nados. I'm going to E-Spirit Barrel the left side. I'm also going to play my Goblin Gang in the middle. I think that was smart. Let's see what he does here. Yeah, that was actually really good. I got like 1,000 damage pretty much. Nice. And then I think I'm just going to cycle arrows on this Ice Wizard. I don't want to play anything else on it. I don't want to take like 200, 300 damage. He sets up a Tombstone. That's fine with me. He might go on the left side because he got 10 damage. Okay, he didn't. He cycles his Evo Knight, but I'm back to mine as well. In this matchup, you need to get back. You can't let him get an Evo Knight over you, or else you just lose. I'm going to barrel in the corner right now. I'm going to play my Goblin Gang as well. And I'm also going to play my Cannon. I mean, my Bomb Tower all the way down low. Yeah, I'll just play it down low. I'm going to cycle my arrows on the both Tombstones. And I'm going to put my E-Spear in the middle as well. Okay, I completely missed it. I might Goblin Gang. No, I'm just going to play my Knight. He's going to go in, so I'm going to block the bridge, actually. Okay, he actually didn't go in. I'm just going to play my Dark Goblin and Goblins down low. He's going to get a really good poison right now. Wait, the King Tower! Oh, dude, that almost activated my King Tower. Okay, I didn't even see the left side. Oops. I'm just going to cycle arrows so it doesn't get too much damage. That's actually really bad. Yeah, that's like 700 damage, and I was going to go for my side as well. I'm going to barrel the corner, though. See what he does right now. Okay, he just plays an Ice Wizard. I don't really agree with that. He has 10 spells. He should have just defended it. I'm going to play my Dark Goblin just to get back to another one. And he's going to go in on the left side, I believe. I mean, right side. I'm going to put my Bomb Tower all the way up high. Nice, I got that. Kill the Baby Dragon, please. Okay, I'm going to put my Goblin Gang. Protect the Dark Goblin. Okay, it didn't. It doesn't matter, though. Oh, wait, did protect the Dark Goblin. Wait, I'm going to put my Knight in front of this. I'm already back to another Dark Goblin, and this should just be a good game right now. I don't think he can stop this. I'm going to play my Peril right now. Okay, he has to poison. Okay, he actually got back to his Evo Knight, so he's going to be able to defend, but it's all dead now, so he can't use his Evo Knight on offense, which is really solid. I think he's going to go in right now, but it would just be terrible if he did. Okay, nice. I'm going to put my E-Spirit Dark Goblin right now on the Baby Dragon. Please kill the Baby Dragon. Okay, I'm going to play my Knight as well, just because Graveyard's broken, so it would have got too much damage. And it's just crazy to me that he's still in this game, just because he's playing Graveyard. I'm just going to play my Barrel right now in the corner. I have my arrows ready. He wasted his Bar Barrel. Okay, he's actually back to it. No, low power. Go away. Okay, I'm going to just play my Bomb Tower right now. He's going to obviously go in. I'm going to play my E-Spirit and Dark Goblin down low. I'm going to play my Goblin Gang as well. My barbs aren't really getting, can't really get much value. That's why I'm not playing them. I'm going to play, okay, I have to play them now or else the Baby Dragon would just splash the tower. I would just put my E-Spirit right now as well as a Dark Goblin. Okay, that was a terrible Bar Barrel. I'm going to barrel right now. I'm going to play my Evo Knight in front of this. Oh no, it actually killed my Dark Goblin. Wait, that's not good at all. This guy's catching up. I'm just getting bored, dude. I'm just going to keep spamming this guy out. I'm going to barrel right now. He's probably going to Bar Barrel the top is my guess. Okay, his Evo Knight just got shredded. I think I just win the game. There's no way you can stop this, right? Okay, he just poisons. He can't poison the tower now. I'm just going to cycle my arrows. I think that's game. Yeah, he can't poison the tower. So yeah, good game against this guy. That was way too close. Alright guys, we're in the next game against this guy. This might be my last game, honestly. I'm still sick, and yeah, I just need a rest. My throat's killing me. Okay, and I'm lagging. Yeah, this is definitely going to be my last game. I'm just going to play my Knight on the left side and then play my Dark Goblin down low on the right. Yo, every time I drop a card, there's like a second delay. This is actually so annoying.
It's whatever, though. It's going to clean up the right side. He has to defend the knight again. He's probably just going to play Spirit or Skeleton. Some one elixir card, I'm assuming. Okay, or not. It's going to be one shot, actually. Yeah, nice. Actually, two shots. Nice. I'm going to put my bomb tower in the middle. This guy's a healer. Really interesting. I didn't think he had a healer. Okay, why does he have EQ in his deck? What is this guy playing with, dude? I'm just going to play my... okay, I'm just going to play my arrows on this. Okay, that I did not need that. Oops. Well, whatever. I'll just put my barbs as well. I could have defended that so much better, but it's whatever. Who cares? He just plays his ghost on that. I'm going to put my E-Spirit Barrel on the right side. Okay, please get down. Thank you. Let's see what he plays on the right. Okay, he just plays arrows. Please kill the ghost. Ghost? Okay, thank you. I don't have to defend the left anymore, so that was actually good. And I can just play a knight if he wants to play a bandit or something. I actually have no idea what this guy is playing, to be honest with you, so I'm not even going to guess. I'm just going to cycle my knight, though, in the back. Okay, I'll cycle it right here, actually. Dude, literally, every time I place a card down, it's like literally a one-second delay. I don't know what's going on, but yeah, this is definitely going to be my last game. I'm just going to cycle my Dark Goblin in the back for some defense. And then he's probably going to play an Eagle in the front of this if he has one. Let's just see. Okay, he just does that. That was smart. I'm just going to play my Barbs right on top of this Ghost. It should clean all this up. Yeah, it should. I'm going to play my Barrel right now. Bro, dude, okay, this game is actually bad. It's not even my game, it's my internet. I'm just going to play my E-Spirit right here. He plays his EQ, so I have to play my Evolved Knight. And the Evo Knight is just so good, dude. Like, it just tanks so much shots. Nice. I'm going to play my Dark Goblin behind this. Actually, wait, yeah, I'm going to play it now. He's going to play his Goblin Gang, I think. I kind of want to predict with arrows. Okay, he actually doesn't. I'm just going to play my Barbs on top of all this right now. I kind of have to. Yeah, that sucks. I don't know what this guy's playing, dude. He's going to play his... Yeah, okay, I can just arrows that. I'm going to also barrel right now. He's probably just going to arrows on the barrel. Let this go. Okay, I'm going to play my Dark Goblin. Okay, bro, what the heck is this guy doing? Please kill that one ghost. Okay, thank you. So I just have to defend one ghost and I'm chilling. I'm just going to play my knight down low as well as an E-Spirit. And I'm going to play my barbs on top of everything right now. And then I'll play my Goblin Gang. Okay, I thought that one Goblin was going to target the tower. That's why I did that. He's going to play his Goblin Gang right now. Okay, yeah, wait, did he just give up? Yeah, he did. There's just no way this guy could have done anything. So yeah, good game. Alright, thank you guys so much for watching this video. I know it's a shorter video. I'm still sick right now, so I don't really have the energy to do it, to be honest. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. Comment best defensive deck if you guys are still watching. So you guys are loyal subscribers, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.